You probably recognize this as the former Daily Courier building on Doyle Avenue in Kelowna. Inside, it's been transformed into a homeless shelter. The official opening is tomorrow, but already half a dozen homeless people have already taken advantage of this new accommodation.
So our team that came together to pull this off has been absolutely extraordinary. And they melded their lives, they turned their lives upside down so that we could actually soft start and start bringing people in over the weekend, slowly bringing people in from the cold, which is the whole point.
Are there another bunch of people that wish they were the lucky 40?
It's yet to be seen how many people will still remain outside. Our estimates are that there may be another dozen or so people that remain outside, even if we're at capacity.
So it looks pretty bare bones. It's warm, it's a place to sleep, not a whole lot else.
Yep, and this is a temporary emergency winter shelter. So the primary purpose of this is to get people inside, to get them safe from the cold, and to feed them, and that's what we do here.
So meals daily?
Yep, we get 3 meals a day here.
All right. And so are there any concerns, any worries? You have people moving in here that sometimes have a complex series of issues. What do you do to keep people secure who are staying here?
Well, and that is the big question, isn't it, Kent?
So I don't envy your task. It's not always easy.
It certainly, if it was easy, we should have gone into a different industry, right? However, we did spend the past 2 weeks in intensive training with our staff, who now have the highest caliber of training for frontline staff, with non-violent crisis intervention, de-escalation, Narcan training, first aid training, food safe training. And so this team is well prepared for the task at hand.
So do you get the feeling that we, at this point, you know, with what we've seen at the Welcome Inn and these other places, do you get the feeling that we're really properly addressing the issue of making sure that everybody can at least stay warm overnight in our community?
We sure are making headway. I mean, if you compare this winter to last winter, this is a massive victory. When we took on this project, we estimated we would be opening December 1st, but everybody sort of had in their mind that that would be by a miracle, and that really if we opened partway through December, if we opened in January, we would still be ahead of where we were last year. And so the fact that we can open this ahead of schedule is just amazing, and we're celebrating that.
The shelter remains open until the end of March. Kelowna Now, this is Kent Molgat reporting.